Support could not have come at a better time. My thanks, Kira. Owing to the tireless efforts of all concerned, we are, at long last, ready to bid farewell to Vesper Bay. So as to avoid drawing undue attention, we shall make the journey to Revenant's Toll in small groups, departing at irregular intervals. Lest you doubt, it is still my intention to conduct future operations openly, but on this particular occasion, the need for caution overrides all other concerns. To move north as one ponderous caravan would only serve to invite attack. It seemed only right that I should be the last to leave, and I would have you remain with me until the very end, Kira. Upon my departure, the Waking Sands will formally cease to be our headquarters, and the premises will be given into the care of Orianje. I thought to relinquish the property, but he was quite adamant, and I had not the heart to disagree. These walls have borne witness to some of the brightest and darkest moments in our Order's history. Mayhap it is best that we do not forsake them entirely. Orianje shall remain here and devote his energies to studying the nature of primals. By the grace of the Twelve, he will one day discover the permanent solution that we sought for so long. Of course, he will not be alone. Alizé shall continue to work closely with him as well. Should they require our assistance, I have their assurances that they will not hesitate to contact us. Speaking of Orianje, would you inquire of him if any tasks remain undone? I cannot escape the feeling that I have forgotten something. Something important. Orianjezies, thou art ever welcome, Kira, but I require no assistance. Pray, take thy leave, unburdened by concern of my well-being. Verily, thy countenance bespeaks a desire to quit this place without further delay. Mayhap thou thinkest this chapter of our tale concluded, that these halls should rightly be consigned to the annals of history. In man's eagerness to see the future, how readily he doth set down the past. Full many a proud pioneer have bravely striden into great unknown, only to find there the banner of his ancestor, faded by the eons. And still, man glorieth in his discoveries. Tis through his pride that wisdom doth ever give way to ignorance, while they who lurk in shadows remain hidden, lost no sooner than they are found. This prose always quotes poetry. Oh, poetic looking. Be not offended, Kira. Thy conduct hath ever been beyond reproach. Despite thy surpassing strength and all thy many victories, thou hast never been so convinced of thine own greatness as to imagine thyself above the failings of thy forebears. Mayhap it is the echo which hath opened thine eyes to the lessons of histories. Would that the same could be said of... Whence came that cry? The solar. 12 for Finn, the antecedent. I'll do it. Happening up in this, we need to get out of this place. Kira, you must. Ah! Beyond mortal measure. Would that I had met him prior to his passing. White? Asian here? How? How readily you see. You are indeed gifted, antecedent. But you're not like the others, you're robes. Gifted, but ignorant. Yet I shall not judge you harshly. The fault lies with your forebears. It has been millennia. Mine are the robes of an emissary. Unlike he who came before, I have no quarrel with you. He who? You speak of La Brea? La Brea is a warrior. He fought, he fell. He may yet learn from his mistakes. He's still alive? Then he is still... Come, I only confirm that which you already knew. There is no cessation, no oblivion, only expulsion. You... What are... Ready when you are, m'lady, if there's nothing else. Something the matter? Ah, I feel the same way. After everything that's happened here, it feels strange to leave, but I'm sure we'll soon get used to Revenant's toll. Well, I'll let you say your goodbyes. Take as long as you like, m'lady. We shall depart whenever you're ready. It is only to be expected. She lacks the gift and the knowledge both. To her, we are indistinct. I don't understand. Shadowless, fleshless, formless. What truth there is in each tale is diluted by a time in telling. Knowledge dictates expectation, and expectation colors perception. Thus did she perceive not. So it is with all but a chosen few. Even you, when young, could not yet see with eyes unclouded. You know nothing about me. Nothing. The gift grants you clarity. It grants you focus. With it, you may in time come to see us as we are, rather than this crude approximation. That's not what they really look like. Ahabrea did not think so highly of the Echo. La Habrea is wrong about a great many things. The Echo is indeed a gift, albeit one you have yet to master. And if we did, there would be no strife between our peoples. We would be of one mind. The heck? This makes no sense to me. I leave, as I came, in peace, Antecedent. May we meet again as friends. Wait, stay where you are. Mayhap I was indelicate. To some mercy she shields her children from his grace with such resolve. Is it also by her hand that she surviveth the ardor? I wonder. That's messed up, bro. Take it there's no need to explain. It's messed up, man. Be hitting up on my woman like that, cuz. Save your concern. He did mean no lasting harm. Whatever his intention was, it was not to kill. I heard a cry. What happened? Are you alright? You look faint. Do you need to lie down? I could fetch you a flask of my special tonic. Rianjay, send word to the students of Baldessian. Tell them to scour the archives, the Forbidden Tomes in particular. If there is any reference to an Assian robed in white, however oblique, I would know of it. An Assian, my lady? Was that what gave you cause to cry out? I did but moments ago glimpse a figure clad in white set forth from the waking sands. Assians are wont to employ teleportation magics. Why would one be so brazen? I know not, and care not. Find him, Kira. Turn every stone in Vesper Bay if you have to. Pray attend me to Taru. Let's go, Tom. I'm told you are the Warrior of Light. But I would know for myself. I shall walk north, and you may choose to follow. Know, however, that you will be waylaid if you do. You may even perish. Should you survive, we shall speak anon. Plan to test me? The Warrior of Might? Let's do this. Thank you. Remarkable. Truly remarkable. I thank you for granting me this indulgence. None save she who bested La Habrea could endure such an examination. Now it's your turn. Have the laws of man grown so twisted in my absence that it is now permitted to lay hands upon an emissary? You bore witness to my audience with the antecedent, did you not? Then you know I acted only in self-defense. I mean, she didn't do nothing to you, stop lying. I realize the same cannot be said of La Habrea. Even amongst his brethren, he is considered unique. Nevertheless, I cannot wholly condemn his misdeeds, for through them we discovered you, one so strong in the gift that she could cast us out. I'm about to cast you out, son. Your mother favors you still, that much is plain, but surely you must feel it. Her influence wanes, and her strength shall soon be spent. These lands, these people, this world, all shall soon change. As it was, so shall it begin. So it shall be again, as it should always have been. Doubt my claims and question my motives, if you will. Only believe me when I say this. I am Elidibus, emissary, bearer of the world of the one true God, and we shall meet again. Black teleport. He's evil! Thank the gods you returned, Kira. After you left, I began to worry that I might have sent you to your doom. I take it our visitor proved elusive. Beg pardon? He was waiting for you? What did you do? What did he say? As it was, so shall it be again? Of when does he speak? And of what exactly? Words of Elidibus portend much, but reveal nothing, save perhaps a measure of disdain for La Habrea. I had hoped for answers, but it seems I shall have to be content with a wealth of additional questions. Let us set aside the matter of this Ascian until we have completed our move to the Rising Stones. There is but one final favor I would ask of you before I depart. I believe I mentioned before that my father was a member of the Alamegan Resistance. The truth, however, is more complicated than that. As far as the Empire knew, he was their spy. He maintained the deception for nigh on half a decade, furnishing the Resistance with vital Imperial secrets while feeding his paymaster subtly conceived misinformation. When he died some 15 years ago, my father left behind his journal, which I have closely guarded ever since. It contains every shred of information he and his agents could steal on what they believed to be the single greatest threat to Eorzea, the Primals. Its wisdom has guided me through the years, though there is much within I still do not understand. It is my hope that Orianje will fare better. Tell him to treat it with care. It is all I have left of my father. I thought thee departed. To what end dost thou linger? I got books, bruh! Father's final bequest, the daughter's lifelong labor. It is no small thing to surrender such a cherished memento. Well can I imagine the antecedent's pain. Upon mine honor, I swear to spare no effort in the study of these materials, lest my lady's sacrifice be in vain. This is Minfilia. Forgive me, but I could wait no longer. I have departed for the Rising Stones. How are you gonna leave me, sucker? If you have yet to... Once you have given the journal to Orianje, I bid you come to the Seventh Heaven in Revenant's Toll. Tataro will be there to show you inside our new headquarters. Assuming you have already attuned to it, you may wish to make use of our new Aetherite in Revenant's Toll. After all, it is right on our doorstep. Tataro. Welcome, Kira. Welcome. This is your first time here, if I'm not mistaken. I think you're going to like our new home. Well, what are you waiting for? Go in and have a look. Very nice. Who are you? realize the Scions had moved until I arrived in Vespera Bay. Thankfully, Orianje was kind enough to direct me here. I know I've only just joined, but if there's anything I can do to help, please let me know. Oh, so he's a new member of the Scion. Ah, thank Grizz. As ravishing as ever. Perhaps for old time's sake, she would. Gods, Kira, don't sneak up on me like that. We bards are an easily started lot. Oh, he's looking at, Fiamin. Oh, you wish to help? That's very kind of you, but I can manage on my own. Besides, you should be out having grand adventures, not withering away here with me. Yeedah! I love the smell of victory in the morning. It smells like sweat. No, no. Muntui sauce. No! Victory! Yeah, victory! So here we are. Completely independent and unquestionably neutral. At least more so than before. Truth be told, I cannot say it feels that different. Of course, Ida begs to differ. Of course she does. Cough, cough, wheeze. The horror. The horror! Reboulder. Ishtola. Some girl right here, cuz. As you can see, our Shalayan allies have furnished us with a wealth of new tomes. Would be prudent for you to broaden your knowledge as well. And Alfino. Is it not wonderful, Kira? Nary a single presumptuous merchant has darkened our door. I know full well they will come in time, but for now, let us enjoy the respite. A new beginning for the Scions of the Seventh Dawn, but today we declare our independence. We shall henceforth be beholden to no nation, but serve all Eorzea's people proudly and openly. But this does not mean that we will sever our ties to the Eorzean Alliance. On the contrary, the antecedent and I shall endeavor to strengthen them. Rest assured, however, that we shall not permit political considerations to influence our decisions. Our identity remains unchanged, as does our cause. We are the Scions of the Seventh Dawn, and our single purpose is to safeguard the future of Eorzea. Hi! For Eorzea! Space. Moment of your time, Kira. I would speak of Elidibus. Yanji. Pardon the intrusion, my lady, but the matter which bringeth me will admit no delay. Mine every attempt to contact the students of Baldessian hath been met with silence. No one will respond? How odd. Allow me to try. Response. Surely they would not ignore us. They have never yet, my lady. I fear we must assume the worst. No. No, I will not believe it. An outpost, perhaps, but not their headquarters. Their wards are beyond circumvention. Had they come under attack, they would most certainly have raised the alarm. None could penetrate their sanctum unnoticed. Except for that white Asian. Before those who lack the gift and the knowledge both. Oh no. Yep. Con- contact their agents in the field at once. If aught has befallen the students of Baldessian, they may know of it. Though the thought of it pains me, until such time as we have evidence to the contrary, we can but assume the worst. Accordingly, we must needs seek another source of information on Elidibus. 'Tis possible that others in the homeland are possessed of such knowledge. Be fairly warned, however, they are unlike to yield it unconditionally. Do what you must.
They want that money, probably.
Yet another unforeseen and unwelcome development. What could be next, I wonder? A visit from a crimson-clad Asian, perhaps? Or Ocher? Puce? And which of our allies will then fall silent? For a time, I thought we had gained the upper hand. When you shattered the Crystal of Darkness and cast out Lahabrea, I dared to hope that we had found a way to rid ourselves of the Asin menace. But I was wrong. He endures and may yet return. Upon that point, I have no doubt that Elidibus spoke true. Yet there must be a way to destroy them utterly. A way to spare this world their unholy machinations. I dare not consider the alternative. There are forces at work we do not understand, Kira. I discern them all around, and disturbances too great and too numerous to be dismissed as mere coincidence. Doubtless the Paragons are involved, but how and to what end is far from clear. I know not what will come, but I do know that we will rise and meet it as one. Amen, sister. Ah, my stalwart hero. Your face is a picture of resolve. I know that you will be ready when the time comes. With luck, however, that will not be a while yet. Pray return to your private affairs with my blessing. Should anything arise, you will be informed. Session was not foretold. You object? We question. Our plans are in motion. Your intentions unclear. They survived the Seventh Order and are stronger now in the gift. Does that not intrigue you? No, it does not. Serve as you will, so too shall I. We labor not at cross purposes. The wisdom of his plans shall become apparent in time. The veil is lifted from their eyes, and at long last they see.